Hi guys, and welcome back to TK Talk YouTube channel. This is Python for Kids course, episode number 4, taking divisions with if statements. Today we will be introducing the if, else, and else statements. Before we begin, we would really appreciate it if you guys gave us a like, subscribe, and turn on the notifications bell so you can be notified whenever we upload a new video. Once upon a time, there was a girl nicknamed
Hello, I named Ride Little Riding Hood.
People gave her that name because she was wearing a little red hood all the time, and every year her grandmother gives her a new and bigger red hood. One day, her mom told her some instructions. Give this basket to your grandmother, who lives on the opposite side of the forest, and do not talk to anyone, especially the big bad wolf. While she was going to her grandmother's house, she forgot the instructions and talked to the big bad wolf. And she told the big bad wolf where she was heading. And the wolf had an evil idea. How about a race to your grandmother's house? The first one to make it there is a winner. Okay. And they began the race. The wolf came there first, and he tricked Little Red Riding Hood's grandmother and ate her. When Little Red Riding Hood arrived, the wolf was about to eat her as well, but the hunter came and rescued Little Red Riding Hood with her grandma, and they lived happily ever after.
Thank you, hunter. Thank you for saving us.
This reflects a simple if statement, because the simple if statements are questions that have multiple conditions with an action or an execution. Obviously, Little Red Riding Hood took bad decisions in this story. Taking decisions in programming is known as an if statement, and it is applied in all programming languages, not only in Python. There are four types of if statement. First one is simple if statement. This is how simple if statement looks like in your code. But before that, let me give you this example. While Little Red Riding Hood was walking in the forest, she passed by an ice cream truck on the way to her grandmother's house, and to take a decision of buying some ice cream. She remembered the instruction that her mom gave her, and she asked herself a question. Am I allowed to stop and buy some ice cream? But her mom's instruction did not include stopping for ice cream in any sort of way, so she decided to leave. As you see, taking a decision in this situation involved two ways, either to stop and buy some ice cream, or to proceed with her trip without stopping. And the decision was taken based on a question, and only its answer chose which way to go with. Let's look at normal code execution and how the introducing of if statements makes difference. I will highlight the normal code execution with blue color. In normal code execution, the flow goes from one cell to the next code cell, and then the next code cell, and so on. Normal code execution is like a subway with several train stations. The train goes from station 1 to station 2 and then station number 3 in sequence without any possibility to escape station of them and jump directly to the next one. Now the if statement will come in the picture with purple color. Do you know what the name of that one stick with two branches? Exactly, it is a slingshot. Hope that did not happen to you. Try to remember this shape of a wooden stick with two branches, because it is our key to decision making and if statement concept. It is like a stem or a main branch, and out of there is a sub branch. Let's color the main branch with blue and the sub branch with purple. Now, let's show our code execution will look like when we introduce the if statement in between. Our subway path will be changed as well, as our main path will be extended and the new alternative path will be created. Also, our code cell train station number 3 will be moved down, and it will have 2 doors this time. One blue door from the left side, opening from the main blue path, and other purple door from the right side to access the train station from the purple alternative path. Now, how the train driver will decide to take the main blue or alternative purple path to reach the same destination code cell station number 3. Here, we will add a new component to our code that looks like diamond, which is a question. That question, as I will explain in a few minutes, called condition. Now, when the answer of this question found to be yes, which means true in programming, as explained in our second video of this course, the execution direction will go through the purple branch and execute additional code called if code. This is like buying ice cream in Little Red Riding Hood example. Finally, the code execution will be directed back to track at next code cell number 3. However, if the answer of this question came to be no, which means in programming false, our program will not execute anything and just move directly to the next code cell number 3. That's what we call bypass, because in this situation, our program will bypass or ignore if code and just do nothing but just proceed to next code cell. This is exactly the case of Little Red Riding Hood when she found the answer is no of her question of am I allowed to stop to buy some ice cream. That is why she decided to do nothing but bypassing or ignoring the ice cream truck and proceeded with her trip to her granny, which is her next code cell. As we saw in the last slide, simple if statement structure, it has something called condition. And condition is nothing but a question or a group of questions that we represented them as purple diamond. And those questions are the kind of closed questions that have only answers with yes or no. As we said, those questions might be a single question or they may be several questions. In case of a condition with multiple questions, we have to use logic operators that we explained in our second video. Let me refresh your memory with the main 2 logic operators, and or. And is when your mom tells you there are no video games until you finish all of your homework. So if you miss a single subject, you will not play. And you will play only if when you finish all of your required things. Try to remember and logic with the word all of your homework. On the other hand, or is when your mom offers you a perfect ice cream, but puts a condition of eating at least one sandwich, either shawarma, tuna, or yummy melted cheese. So you have to eat at least one sandwich, any of them, and to get your ice cream. You may also eat 2 sandwiches or even all of them, and you still deserve your ice cream. Try to remember or logic conditioned with the word any. Second, the if-else statement. As we get deeper with the if statement execution, there are more other ways than just bypassing with false answers. Let me summarize to you what we have learned so far. Here's our stick that represents the two branches that will be created after the if statement condition question. The blue line represents doing nothing in case of false answer and just go forward directly to the next cell code. That is what we called bypassing. While the purple line on the other branch shows the if statement code execution when the answer is concluded as true. So we have cell code before the if statement and code cell after it. And in between the if condition question along with the true pass, and in case of false answer, we just escape everything and went to the next cell code. Now with the second type of if statement that we call if else statement, we will have the capability to execute also a code in false answer instead of just bypassing, and we will call it else code. Example of that: I want to play video games now. The condition could be, is the internet available in my house now? In case of true, I will play an online game like Roblox. In case of false, I'll play an offline game like FIFA on my Xbox. Next is type number 3 of the if statements, the if else statement. In a real life example, it looks more like this big tree branch. The biggest twig on the right represents the if true condition execution, and the smaller twigs are the if else code as I will show you in seconds. If else statements are used in the case of multiple scenarios. As before, there are code cells before and also code cells after. In between, we have if condition diamond. In case of true answer, it will execute if code exactly like previous types and go the code cells after. Now, in case of false, it will move to another condition, which is a first else condition this time. And once again, in this case of true answer, it will execute the else code and go to the code cells after. That process will be repeated as many times as you have a number of else conditions. Finally, the last else condition with false answer will move directly to the next code after and ignores executing any code as all condition answers are false. Last type of if statements is if else else statement, which is the same execution and code of previous type if else, except the else code that will be injected along with the last false answer instead of just bypassing. In this video, we have shown you the decision making in programming and if statement execution concept. What does condition mean and what are the different kinds of if statements? In the next video, we will make some code together with if statement. We will create rock, paper, scissors, game with Python. And lastly, we will apply if statement concepts in our main project. The project, which we explained last video, to show you how the robot could classify the fruits in different boxes.
Please do a thrive!
From now to next time, it is preferred to watch this video many times to ensure your understanding. Also, you may review previous videos in this course to refresh your memory. And watch other ongoing Raspberry Pi course videos as well. See you in the next video.